Sie fand sich selbst. Thank you. Her name was Madeline Green, but they called her Moazam Beak because she wore a beak over her face when she would go out. She was born without a chin and lips and was very self-conscious of this. She could swallow a trout whole and store leftovers in her gullet like a pelican's bill. Very handy indeed. She had no desire for friendship, but she wanted to love. Perhaps some other unfortunate with a pumpkin head or a kind fellow with a lizard tongue, which she didn't have much luck with that. Anywho, she lived in a kipper house, wet and scaly and full of guts, but cozy enough and a bit of sea louse problem. She didn't mind that too much. It got ripe at noon, so she would take a stroll through the town for some breezy chip, stop by the vendor with her oily sack, and ask for it to be filled and speed passing the terraces and arcades on the way home. She spotted a grey hand poking out of the sand, curled up like a dead spider in the broad heat. She took a knee and gave it a tickle, and to her surprise, it loosened a little. She grabbed it with a firm grip and released this dexterous pilgrim from its gritty deposit. To her surprise, it was the arm, torso, and head of a handsome man, rugged and windswept. She blushed and shyly mumbled in her lipless lingo it was okay, and could maybe use a place to stay. Torso slumped and his head fell forward in an agreeable knot. She danced with joy, then quickly composed herself. She clears her throat. Let me carry you, it's only a short way, she says, with happiness in her voice. Torso slumps for their agreement. Excellent, she shouts, and gently holds a rigid arm to her shoulder, lifts torso to her back, and skips back to her shack. Inside, she cleans his tortured body and sets him by the fire to dry, lays by his side and cuddles his coldness away, lights a row of candles and reads him extracts from an autumn country journal, and deposits crisp crab cakes into his dry, cracking mouth, serenades him as best she can with moonlight on her mind from a piddle tin whistle. Oh, joy is mine and life is ours, she sings, drifting away into his deep nightmares. Out eye sockets.